Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.2, Problem 2. This is Section 9.2, Problem number 2. It says, determine the value of T sub C, the confidence coefficient, for each of the following confidence intervals. So the first one is a 95% confidence interval with a sample size of 24. So there's a T chart in your book, in the homework, and what you have to do is find the right column and the right row and see where they intersect. So the column that you look for is 1 minus the confidence as a decimal over 2. So for 95% confidence, that would be 1 minus 0.95 over 2. So 1 minus 0.95 is 0.05 over 2. So when you divide that, you might want to do it on your calculator. You can just enter 0.05 divided by 2 equals, and it'll tell you it's 0.025. So that's the column, 0.025. Now, which row you want is determined by the sample size. So you want, that's the one that says DF, for degrees of freedom. You want one less than the sample size. So this first part A, if the sample size is 25, would need 24 degrees of freedom. So you want to see where that 0.025 column intersects with 24 degrees of freedom. And if you look, the point where they would intersect is 2.064. So that would be the value of your confidence coefficient that we label T sub C in the formula. So for part A, it would be 2.064. So it's the same process for B, C, and D. So for a 90% confidence interval with a sample size of 16, again, determine the correct column, determine the correct row, and see where those two intersect with each other. So the column will come from 1 minus the confidence level as a decimal divided by 2. So for 90% confidence for B, you'll do 1 minus 0.90 divided by 2. So 1 minus 0.90 is 0.10 divided by 2, which would be 0.05. And again, you can do as much of this as you want on the calculator as you feel comfortable with. I think of it as money. 1 minus 90 cents is 10 cents, half of 10 cents is 5 cents. But if you want, do it all on the calculator. So 0.05 is the correct column for a 90% confidence interval. Now, what about the row? The row is determined by the sample size. The number of degrees of freedom should be 1 less than the size of the sample. So if we have a sample size of 16, that would give us 15 degrees of freedom. And when you go to that chart and you see where 0.05 intersects with 15, it would intersect at 1.753. So as you fill in the formula for the confidence interval, that T sub C variable would have a value of 1.753, and that's for B. So again, same process once again for C. We want to have a 99% confidence interval that has a sample size of 36. Determine the correct column based on your level of confidence, the correct row based on your size of the sample, and see where they intersect. So for the column, same process, 1 minus the level of confidence as a decimal, so 99% would be 1 minus 0.99, you would divide that by 2. So that would be 0.01 divided by 2. 0.01 divided by 2 is 0.005. And again, you can do that work on a calculator if you like. The decimals I'm very comfortable with, but if you're not, it takes just seconds to do with a calculator. Now, the 0.005 is the column you want to look in. What about the row? So if we have a sample size of 36, we would have 1 less for the number of degrees of freedom, which would determine the row. So if we have a sample size of 36, you would look in the row with 35 degrees of freedom and see where that 35 degrees of freedom row intersects with the point 005 column, and it would intersect at 2.724. So that's the answer for C. If you have a 99% confidence interval with a sample size of 36, when you fill in the confidence interval formula, the T sub C variable would have a value of 2.724. And finally, part D, we have an 80% confidence interval with a sample size of 9. So the level of confidence will determine which column of that chart we want to look in. So we do 1 minus the level of confidence as a decimal. So 1 minus 0.80 over 2. 1 minus 0.80 is 0.20. And when you divide that by 2, 0.20 divided by 2 is 0.10. Which you could write as 0.1. I again, think of it in terms of money, 10 cents is what I get. Now, the 0.10 is the correct column to look in. So the row is going to come from the size of the sample. If we have a sample size of 9, that would give us 8 degrees of freedom. Again, one less than the size of the sample. So we see where that 0.10 column will intersect with the 8 degrees of freedom row. And it would intersect at 1.397. Again, as you fill in the confidence interval formula, the value for T sub C in this case for part D would be 1.397.